Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, the Fortnite World Cup Finals Duo Competition begins right now.
Jesus, this is going to be intense. I mean, there's nothing more, honestly, nerve-wracking than the initial launch. Off the bus, man. You're flying. Someone's going to die. Someone's going to be eliminated. Who's going to be the first one?
Yep.
You don't want to be the first one knocked out in the World Cup. I mean, literally, I knocked him, like, you know, it was the first game in the Pro-Am, and that was just amazing. You can't live that down. I don't want to be the first person knocking this.
No, for sure. As now we immediately hop on board with my pick to dominate today, Benji Fishy and Mr. Savage, and they're heading right towards Happy Hamlet, a place they've called home so many times, and this is contested.
It's already contested.
You're flying on into here, Ninja. The early game so key, and already Benji Fishy trying to put shots down range with that revolver, but area is contested. You see they're kind of split from each other right now. What are their comms like in this exact moment?
I mean, I think right now they're just going to be trying to hear exactly where these guys are, footsteps. Any type of information they can pass off to one another is going to be very important. They've been practicing this landing. I'm pretty sure I've watched these guys play literally every week because they're from EU, so they were before NA qualifiers. Yeah. And yeah, this is exactly where they normally land. Savage and Benji, they don't always land on top of one another. And you're honestly at a disadvantage if you do land in the same house because you're going to be getting less shields of one another, right? Less chances of getting shotguns and things like that. And I'm just interested to see how they're going to play this out. Are they going to be aggressive? Are they going to back down?
Well, we just saw the first zone has been revealed, and it is a northern side zone, so anyone in Happy Hamlet, not safe. Full of Peak, Frosty Flights, Paradise Palms, Lucky Landing, all not safe. As we continue to keep an eye on this fight, 98 players remaining right now in this game. Now, we mentioned the increased material farming right now. So you're hitting a couple trees. You're getting 20, 30 materials like it's nothing. Let's shift our focus, though, towards the middle of the map here at Dusty Divot. And it looks like Landjock and Punisher go out very, very early in this first game to Tetra and Eclipse, the new rogue members.
They're wasting a lot of material right now. You can already see it. We've got only a map left. That's 10 builds. These early game fights are always so detrimental. You have to be very, very, very particular with how many mats you're going to use when you're trying to ramp rush somebody, because if you make it there and they shoot you out and you have no mats, I mean, you're left with literally nothing to protect yourself with.
And look at the advantage that you now have. Tetra hasn't found any shields, but because two eliminations come on through, he gets both. That's 50 shield per elim, putting him at max HP, and now he can completely change how he takes this fight. It's not like the normal games where you're still stuck at 100 health and you might second guess what you want to do. You might play a little more passively. No, because of those early elims, they now have Dusty Divot to themselves. They pushed out the Asian duo, pushing towards that top Dusty Divot side of XXM and Mend. And now they're sitting pretty. Divot all to themselves. They've got metal galore here, as well as wood. The one material they'll really be lacking is going to be stone.
Yeah, definitely going to be lacking stone. They can get a 500 metal, which is going to be their most valuable asset here, landing in Dusty. What I'm just interested to see is, you know, they have no rotation items when you're looking over there. So hopefully they find something that's going to help them rotate later. There are no balls that spawn in Dusty. So no ballers. It's going to be very difficult to make it to the late game if you guys don't have some sort of crazy rotation. Shadow bombs, anything like that.
Here's another fight going on towards Fatal Fields. And with how little materials there are, you got to think these players down low who are already just on light HP are in a tough spot. And there it is. Scarlet and his duo, Bell, get the quick elimination on the Brush. And that's going to push back Brush's duo into Fatal Fields to try to hide for a brief moment. Another rough start right there. So much stone in Fatal Fields. I feel like Fatal Fields is a underrated landing spot.
I think you can get everything at Fatal Fields. You definitely get wood and brick very quickly, and then there's definitely some metal that you can gather around. You know, there's a bunch of cars and things like that. Some tractors there in the sticks. But listen, man, I'm really curious as to why they're not pushing Sizz.
Well, it's a double-edged sword too, because yes, Sizz is by himself, but we've all experienced how easily you can hide in that brush there in the cornfields. And Sizz Lucky, these top players who land Fatal Fields know how to actually navigate the loot in the corn without breaking the corn. So
I need to break the corn every time.
Right, same. I'm not good enough to know. But there's a certain path you can go on, and Sizz Lucky will actually be able to go back and pick up Brush's card. So this is key.
You think you should go
reboot
for it?
Vans, remember, when you get brought back, you only have 100 HP
and a
common pistol. That will bring a lot of attention over. If you are Scarlet and Bell, are you sprinting back over to that fight? I think so. Now across the map, though, an engagement going out between KBB, Yuang, and his, their duo up against Vinny and Zexro, and there's the knock right there, Ninja.
Drum shotgun's very powerful. It's definitely underrated. You can get inside somebody's one by one right there. I mean, there's another knock with the drum shotgun, just absolutely wreaking havoc. Yuwing trying to take this wall. I think his teammate is not going to be able to stay alive, so it's going to be Zex and Yu. He's got the shield advantage. All he has to do is play this patient. I'm pretty sure that these guys don't have that many materials, so just needs to spray it out and hopefully find a chance to take him down, but he's healing up.
Yeah, Zexro has minis as well as big shield, so we'll be able to get back the full shield, and Yuwing now in a tough spot. Do I try to go?
Zex definitely can interrupt this now. He took too long to start going with the res, but it looks like he's just going to be going for the reloads, taking his time, and he looks might be dipping out, maybe trying to... He's definitely staying aggressive, but he's going to get the revive off, and now it's a two-on-one again.
Zexro staying confident, though. No, knowing right now, still at over 150 HP. The teammate has to be at 30 health. The wall comes through, trying to spray it, and it's not going to happen. And you see Zexro right there, hands right to his head. Some solid damage done, but Yuwang dropped down to 59 HP. But with that elimination, we'll bump back up to over 100. Very, very close right there, Ninja, with the drum shotgun.
Very important is checking out the storm right now. A lot of these players, there's a lot. You guys can't see the screen, but there are plenty of people who are outside. They're going to have to start their rotations in. And this is actually where a lot of very talented players with their aim can clean up a lot of kills. This is actually my teammate and I's reverse. Our strategy was to try to get in those spots where you can beam people who are going to be flying throughout the sky using a lot of the slipstreams and just taking advantage of, you know, your incredible accuracy.
A little update, too, on SizzLucky. They did get the reboot in Fatal, so they're both back in play. Look at how slow this lobby is going, folks. 92 players left, and a definite fan favorite here, Nate Hill and Funk of FaZe Clan, currently set on up near Lazy Lagoon. And Ninja, this is your landing spot that you went with your duo reverse. What are maybe some little tips and tricks for players at home who like to land here?
Yeah, all right, so there's, if you go on the boat, on the ship, every single one of the masts is like worth 200 wood, so you definitely want to go for those. You can easily get max wood in Arena. In probably less than 10 seconds. And also there are some metal anchors in town that you can get for about 300 metal, which is, you know, like the most valuable material that you can get. I mean, I'm just 91 players. I mean, have we talked about Storm Surge? I mean,
we haven't yet. I was going to let that be a bridge when we cross it, but
because 91 people left, I mean, how soon is it going to be?
We're going to have Storm Surge in every game.
Yeah, I mean, so, it's going to be like, this is going to be nuts. You guys don't know what Storm Surge is. Basically, the team that has done the least amount of damage is going to start taking damage until they get above their damage threshold.
Yes, and it tells the players on their screen what the damage threshold is. If you're used to playing at home, you probably have never experienced Storm Surge in a normal game, but it is very common in competitive because everyone wants to last until late game, earn those extra points, and wind up getting those placement points to come on through. Watching Letwick and Fwexy right now, it's so scrappy, Ninja. It's not your normal game where you get to loot up and freely grab everything you want. Here, I mean, look at the inventory. A common heavy assault rifle, two heavy bullets.
Yeah, I mean, people are not going to be able to loot. They're not going to be able to loot normally. I mean, you have every single spot is definitely going to be contested or have talented players who are surrounding you. You got to be constantly worried about getting sniped from the side. All it takes is 2 seconds of being caught off guard, and you can get dinked twice with an infantry rifle, and boom, there goes, you know, 160 health, man, just like that.
89 players left now in the lobby as Twiz and Cover H, the duo, do get cut down. 45 duos remaining. The second zone has just been revealed, and again, Storm Surge we'll begin after that. I absolutely think it's going to happen. That will be for 70-plus players. So you keep that in mind as this goes on. Players who haven't really done any damage will know that they're going to be at a point where their hand is going to be forced. They're going to have to put on a little bit of aggression. You're going to see the game pick up just a little bit here. There's Snappy and Red Rush already in the next zone. They're more than happy to just farm up this metal structure and claim it as their own.
They're actually very centralized as well.
Yep.
I mean, a really great strategy that you're going to see a lot of people are going to be using throughout this weekend in solos and in duos is to just try to get in the dead center of the second zone and honestly just kind of pray that the circle is going to continue to rotate in your favor. I mean, I'm still looking at a lot of these guys' inventories. One guy just gets knocked in front of him, but like, he's going to try to save his teammate. It's not going to happen. But there's not a lot of rotation items. I haven't seen a lot of shockwave grenades. I haven't seen a lot of shadow bombs. I don't see any launch pads in anyone's inventory.
Yeah.
It's going to be such a, like, the rotations late game are going to be nuts. People are going to get lasered out of the sky.
And Letwick now all by himself in a 1v2 as his teammate did go down. You see Parpy and Volks still quite healthy between the two of them. Over 140 HP for both of them. Parpy still playing the slow ground, trying to spray out the opponent. And look at the material count for Volks. 135 total builds. It does look like Letwick just kind of ran away, but I don't believe Letwick was able to grab his teammates' reboot card. So we'll basically be by himself the rest of this game.
you know, it's going to be almost impossible to perform alone when your teammate is knocked. And there's the Storm Surge warning. These guys are 106 above it. You guys can see that, which means that there's somebody who has 106 damage less than them that is currently below the threshold, and they are going to need to hit some people, deal some damage. And that's actually the beauty of Storm Surge, right? You don't necessarily only want people kind of just lingering around in their one-by-ones, praying that the circle moves to them. You're gonna see some fights that are going to be forced to break out because players need to get above that, or they're going to die. They're not going to be able to make it.
Now moving towards the Dusty Divot Diner. You see Clicks
and
Skeptic.
I didn't even know you could farm this.
Yeah, the very young duo from NA East, and you just said yourself, I didn't even know you could farm this.
I didn't even know you could get down there.
This is the beauty of it, right? These are the top players in the world showing off the little things that they know that really no one else can pick up on. Many teams already stacking here as there's so many materials to be farmed on up. And for a lot of players, Ninja, once they get max, they don't just stop there. They keep farming to have an excess for more if they need to expend a lot of materials quickly. Yes. On the bottom right of your screen, you see a fight going down in Salty Springs. A lot of grenades being thrown right there. That's going to be Serpent and Hype.
Serpent and Hype in a pretty decent spot. Yeah. Seeing, if you guys can look on the minimap that we're staring at, every single team is now in the safe zone. Everyone is safe in the next circle. It is moving in. Double heavy sniper is in play. For those of you guys who do not know, a heavy sniper will take out a metal wall. It'll take out pretty much anything. It does 1,500 damage to structures. So if you have two teammates who have double heavy snipers, they can see a team line up a shot of somebody hiding in a one-by-one and be able to take them out.
And that changes the game completely. Once you hear double heavy, you can no longer sit still ever. Or if you know where they're at, you have to make sure you have at least two walls of cover on that side to protect you from the inevitable double snipe. And when we say double snipe, it's as far as one, two, three, shoot. And they both fire at the same time and catch
no
you off
time
guard.
To react. There's absolutely zero time to react. And one thing you guys we've talked about are the rotation items. We got six shadows for this guy, and they have a baller, so they're sitting pretty. I think these guys are in a great spot.
Absolutely. And you see the zone did just update towards the northern side of this current storm. Storm Surge is now in play, so players beginning to drop. 80 players in total in this game. They will just rotate on out of here. Hype and Serpent
don't want the fight.
And uh-oh, that's Jay now quite weak. With Storm Surge beginning to tick in, Quinton and Lanouf now having to push a fight as Storm Surge is affecting them as well. And you see it just kind of smites them down from the heavens, and there they go, getting dropped by Storm Surge. Unfortunate for them, but again, with not enough damage done, they do fall below that threshold.
Jeez, man, Storm Surge really does just force people into some pretty tricky situations. But again, man, it just goes to show a lot of aggressiveness is going to pay off for teams, man. You don't want to be put in that situation where, you know, you have to desperate and push. Maybe a duo that's better than you in combat. You know what I mean? And Airwax and Nikov just
That's a replay.
Went, was that a replay? They just went down.
Airwax and Nikov are winners. Well, Airwax, at least, are back-to-back winner of the Pro-Am. Does go down. Airwax double qualified as well. Tough first game for them as they do go out quite early on. 71 players left in this game. 38 duos. Again, it's a slow crawl as everyone begins to drop. Have you ever seen anything like this in competitive?
No, I think that the only time that we saw numbers like this were when the circles were, they didn't really chunk that much and they were more centralized in the beginning of competitive. So really no one had to rotate that much and no one had to fight. So now that these circles are really just kind of moving around the map, you can't really predict them. I mean, you're getting these players who have, again, the great aim, and they're just beaming people who are focusing on trying to rotate into the circle. Now look, there's so many people coming from the south right now. And it's just free kills if you guys are in a top position with solid aim, man. You're going to Texture right now, already getting beamed. He's spamming the space bar, trying to make it as difficult as possible to hit. He sees a lot of, look at it, already trying to figure out right now, where's he going to land? Look at all these people who are already boxed up. They're already creating these tunnels. More shots coming down. And he's going to be able to make it. Eight grenades. So that's going to be, I mean, if he can get in a position where some players are already getting focused on the outside, eight grenades, he might be able to clean up those kills too.
Yep, that's right there. They do box up in time. Did take some shield damage, but thankfully they have some minis to replenish that in just a few brief moments as there's Eclipse now using them. He's got his teammate right next door as well. Medkit, looks like they're gonna pop that too. Every little bit of HP matters. Saving the campfire for the late game, it appears.
Ronaldo gotta save the campfire.
In the elimination feed right there. Here's a look at Mongrel earlier with his duo Mitro. They're set up currently in this zone. 68 players left.
Love watching this guy play, man. I'm serious. I mean, here's, you just check his inventory. Only got two guns right now, which is an inventory rifle and a combat shotgun. So he has no spray guns. All right, spray guns are, you know, anything to an SMG, tactical assault rifle, SCAR, anything like that. You know, you gotta have to have a gun that can shoot pretty quickly to kill players and hit players through their one-bys. You know, very difficult. Look at that healing too, though.
Yeah.
Five slurps, two slurps, five chug splashes.
And they already have a slurp ticking. This is insane.
They're super close to the zone as well. They don't have to move too far.
Yep. And material wise, look at that. 135 total builds. They're in a fantastic position to make some noise in game number one. We'll definitely keep up to date with them. The slipstream slowly inching towards where it begins to shut down Ninja, but with so many slipstreams still available in this current zone, a lot of players are going to use that to rotate on in freely without using launch pads or the shadow bombs. There's your whole map right there, the eastern side of the zone. None of these players really going to be into play. They're going to have to inch a little bit more towards Loot Lake if they want to be safe.
Some of the best, I mean, look, these are the best players in the world, and look how close they are to one another, man. I'm so excited where they actually have to force into these fights. The storm's going to start pushing them. Look how, I'm sorry, man. I just can't, man. You guys notice also, Stinks, man, these players are so talented. It's going to be so hard to spray through their walls and actually deal damage to them.
Yep.
So you need things like grenades, like Stinks, right? Little fart bombs is what I like to call them, to force people out of their one-by-ones and try to shoot them as they're rotating away and trying to build new one-by-ones to dodge the Stinks.
You see the Stinks right now going down on Mongrel! And Mongrel gets immediately ripped in two as it seemed like the lobby began to focus him right there. His duo still alive.
With good rotation, luckily. Hopefully.
Definitely has a bunch to, you know, to be able to play with. The next Storm Surge has begun to kick on in. Intro. 12 damage below, will have to begin to put shots down range. The zone pushing as well. So in this position, with the zone at their back, Mitro's goal, spray at players who have to push from the zone. They have one way they can go. They can't afford to take storm damage. They've got to push right at him, and Mitro knows that. Now begins the fire. Dubs just below as well. One of the players who qualified multiple times through solos and then once in duos.
They also have some great rotation. Two ballers still intact. And here's the thing that you just mentioned, all these players who are going to be rotating in, being forced to rotate in, everyone knows that.
Very little ammo, though. Look, these are the last nine assault rifle shots in Dubs' inventory. It is getting scrappy, folks.
Just got
and there's
split.
The split. Still, though, only 80, meaning combined between the two, they really only have about 150 shots to work with. The zone still pushing. 61 players left. Reminder, folks, this is game number one of six today in the duos competition. Dubs does go down as a player got that back wall. He wasn't quite ready for it. Mega frantically backing on up, trying to create some space. Will he be able to go?
He's gonna
go
be able to
for
pop
the
that He's got
he the storm surge on.
He's trying to be aggressive. Oh, he's still below, right? He's gonna need to be aggressive. He won't even have time to revive his teammate. His teammate got finished, actually, so he's got all the shields in the world. He can get back up to full health. Storm Surge is still ripping him apart. That slurp is barely keeping him alive.
Hitting him for 25 damage every time it winds up ticking. There it is again, dropping on in. Mega's hand is forced. Some big damage right there, still below, as players are continuing to drop all around. But Mega doing a solid job of keeping himself alive right now through the Storm Surge. Fantastic composure again, one of the young players on this stage looking to try to secure the title of Fortnite World Champion. No more Dubs, the duo
still
okay, down.
So now he's finally above. Finally above, and guess what? The most important thing to realize, guys, look at that rotation. Yes, he's alone. Yes, his teammate's down. But he has an incredible kit to not only make it to late game, but maybe even clutch this win out.
He dropped the shotgun. Okay, there you go.
Got the combat shotgun, one of the greatest shotguns to have late game. Does incredible damage, long range and close range. And all the guys in the circle just rotated now into the storm. Massive amounts distance needs to be covered.
This storm surge is insane. It's still going on.
Finally taken out. 52 players left. And this is where things are about to get serious, guys.
Thomas drops some ammo right there for his teammate, Inclusia. And you see, Thomas, that epic infantry rifle, one of your favorite weapons, Ninja. What is so good about that assault rifle?
It 100% rewards pinpoint accurate players, right? There's no bloom necessary. Your marker, your aim is right on their head. Boom, you're gonna get that headshot. You're gonna get 80 points of damage. And there's now the upgraded versions, the legendary and the epic, have 10 shots instead of 8. So, I mean, it just packs a punch, man. It can really catch players off guard. And that's exactly what you're going to need when you're playing against these top players who will literally build and protect themselves when they get shot once.
Folks, there are 45 players left in this very, very small zone. We are now on our sixth storm. You see, it's about to begin to move, and players will frantically have to go across the map. Zate and Saf right now discussing exactly what they should drop, pulling up their map, looking exactly where they have to go. 44 left in this one.
We already got people using shockwave grenades. Guys, this is a very far rotation for the second movement circle. So this is actually going to move very quickly. These people are going to potentially get stuck on their launch pads because there's so much frequent building. It's going to be nuts. And who's going to try to take the high ground? Because after this first circle goes, this is where people start to only try to use the high ground.
And we know high ground is everything in competitive Fortnite late game. Everyone frantically moving away from the common enemy of everyone, which is that storm circle. Macwood taking zone damage, Daedra as well, King slowly bouncing on through with the Shadow Bomb, and
he does land. Storm?
Yes, but taking no storm damage, just playing right on the edge. Yeah, right on the edge of the zone right now. Will just stay boxed up for a brief moment, as now there's 36 players remaining. Stompy in the elimination feed. Arkram now goes down as well. You can see the elimination feed on the top left to keep track of your favorite players. There's so much is going on. This is what tunneling is. When you hear players mention tunneling, this is it right here. You move with the zone, you tunnel your way, and give yourself cover, but not a lot of materials left. Only 22 builds, and this zone is stacked. But look who's on the high ground. It's Mr. Savage and Benji Fishing.
That would be your two picks, so good for you. All right, I have to owe you a bet there, man. That, all right. Bongo, unfortunately, do we still have Mitro still alive? I mean, listen, people are dying left and right, being eliminated. More Savage just used another shockwave grenade. He already had high ground, though. The question is, are people going to try to take it? You know that if you really want the chance to win this, you're going to have to try to take the high ground off him or have a rocket launcher to just take him out of it.
This is so weak, and Mr. Savage just looks up and beams the player out of the air. It's all Benji, Fishy, and Mr. Savage in the elimination feed right now. 24 players left in this one. But
almost
20
no
duos. There's almost no duos remaining, Ninja.
Right, this is all solos, and this is kind of what's going to happen, man.
Mr. Savage goes down.
It's up to Benji. And listen, Benji's been in this position before. We know he can handle it. Mitro's still in the game as well. I just saw him. He looks incredibly healthy, but now taking some storm damage. Benji's just going to try it. Look at the materials. Not a lot left. They're only using their shadows. I think he has one build left.
Yep.
That's it. That's all he has.
He's got 10 total builds.
10 total builds.
He's just trying to outlast as many players as possible. Remember these placement points. We've made it into our top 10 duos. Now into our top 8. Zayt and Saf.
They're
now on the high ground.
This game.
One of the few, the only duo left. This has a Zayt and Saf win written all over it. Mitro, Mongrel's duo. Was all by himself very early on. Still alive in this one. 40-yard storm now getting beamed. Can the North American duo of Zayt and Saf close this out? Raining down fire from up top. You see the frantic builds coming in. Benji Fishy goes down. Mega, Mitro, and Scarlet on the low ground. Shots still coming on in. Zayt and Saf just sitting pretty.
God, Mitro just got a double, I think.
Mitro
five limbs.
Tries to get it done. Not enough. Zayt and Saf, 2 versus 1. Will they take game number 1? Yes, they will.
Zayt and Saf had the high ground.